Hey everyone, this is John Dickinson, Director of Motion Graphics for Boris Effects, and I'm excited to share with you some of the new enhancements to Particle Illusion in Continuum's 2020.5 release. Introduced in Continuum 2019, Particle Illusion was a powerful addition to the Continuum toolset, and now in Continuum 2020.5, the inclusion of powerful new force and turbulence options take it to the next level, enabling you to create more natural, organic particle simulations. Prior to this release, force objects in Particle Illusion were a simple area that accelerated particles based on the strength of the force. We can adjust things like strength and angle to have the force affect the particles. We could add multiple forces to try and get a more organic and random look. But as you can see, this is quite a long way of doing it, and thankfully is no longer necessary, because in Particle Illusion 2020.5, under Type, we have these new options, Grid and Point. Choosing Grid divides the force object into multiple grid cells, and you can see each cell has its own direction arrow. By default, they're all pointing in the same direction, but by choosing Grid, we now have these new parameters, Grid X, Grid Y, Strength Variation, and Direction Variation. If I change Direction Variation, notice how each of the arrows now points in a different direction. And this is already giving us a much more natural, organic look in just a few seconds. Adjusting the strength variation means that as the particles move from cell to cell in the grid, they're going to have different velocities. And this is going to give us an even more dynamic and natural look. By animating the position and rotation values of the force, we can have the particles move in an even more turbulent and organic way. And by adding multiple forces, you can create realistic simulations like this one, where I've animated the force through the text to make it appear as if it's being blown away like dust. The other new and very useful force type is the point force. You can see it also has its own custom parameters, and I can adjust the radius and minimum distance either here, or I can actually drag on the heads-up display in the scene. You can see as I do that, the particles change direction, and that's because the particles are being attracted to the point force's center point. And in this example, we have multiple point forces, some with positive strength values, which attract the particles, and others with negative strength values, which repulse the particles. So as you can see, you can use these together to control the direction and the flow of the particles. And force shapes, of course, can be combined to create realistic simulations like this fiery text. Or this visually dynamic example, where the particle streams appear to collide. The Particle Illusion library is absolutely huge, and while you can use the search option to find an emitter, the inclusion of a new favorites option in 2020.5 makes it easier than ever to get access to your most used emitters. Simply find the emitter that you want, click on it, and then as long as you're in list or grid view, simply click on the star, and that will add that to the favorites list. To view the favorites list, just click on the favorites button, and there's your favorite. Also in this release are several new presets that combine forces with particles, plus a collection of retro-look emitters to expand the Particle Illusion library. There's also some new interface performance enhancements in Particle Illusion 2020.5, and you'll notice this when scrubbing the current time indicator and various different parameters. Okay, so with these Particle Illusion enhancements, you'll be working faster and getting more sophisticated results in Continuum 2020.5. And thanks so much for watching. This is John Dickinson for Boris Effects. Be sure to visit borisfx.com to take a free trial of Continuum and to see more videos about all of the Boris Effects products.